Lakshmi Priyanka, Assistant Professor, St. Martin's Engineering College, Durpalli. So today I am going to explain you another topic, that is jet transform. So jet transform, as already in previous videos I told you, it is also a very important mathematical tool. So by using this jet transform, we will be able to process only on discrete time signals. So up to now, whatever mathematical signals you learnt in signals and systems subject, that is maybe a Fourier series, Fourier transform, Laplace transform. So it will process only on continuous time format or continuous time version of signals. So if you wanted to process on discrete time version of signals, you have to use the mathematical tool that is called as jet transform. So jet transform is also having two types. One is bilateral and unilateral. Okay, bilateral and unilateral jet transform. So bilateral means this is also called as two-sided jet transform, and here unilateral jet transform means so it is including only one-sided of the jet transform. But by coming to the equation representation, jet transform equation is represented as sigma n equal to minus infinity to infinity x of n into z power minus n. So this is the equation. Then if you observe here, sigma summation is there. Here the limits are starting from minus infinity and ending at plus infinity. Means it indicates that this is the bilateral Laplace transform. And the another one is unilateral Laplace transform. How the equation has to be represented means sigma n equal to 0 to infinity x of n z power minus n. So here you can observe the difference clearly. The limits are starting from 0 to infinity. Or you can also write as, or you can also write as sigma n equal to minus infinity to 0 x of n z power minus n. Like this you can write. Means what is the variation here? If you observe this bilateral z transform, the limits are from minus infinity to plus infinity. Means that is including both sides of the plane. So here the plane means we will call it as jet plane. Okay, and here this jet transform, whatever it is there, so it is starting from 0 to infinity. That means it is indicating right handed side of the signal. And here if you observe, this is starting from minus infinity to 0. Means it is indicating left handed side of the sequence. That is the difference between bilateral and unilateral. That means this is called two sided sequence. So the suitable or apt name is two sided sequence. Sequence you have to call, not signal, because here you will be using x of n, means discrete time signal. Discrete time signal means what? It is a combination of samples, means you are representing the sequence of signals. So that's why you can call it as two-sided sequence, and this unilateral can be called as one-sided sequence. Okay, this is the main important first two points relating jet transform. Then we have to learn about this one-sided transform, two-sided are there. So this one-sided, two-sided, if you observe it in clear, in depth, so this one-sided sequence can also be called as casual sequence or one-sided sequence. Okay. Or it can also be called as right-handed sequence. Okay. Right-handed sequence. And then non-casual sequence, or it can also be called as left-handed sequence. So casual sequence or right-handed sequence, non-casual sequence or left-handed sequence. And then the third one comes, which is called two-sided sequence. Okay, two-sided sequence. So here, especially before going into these three types of problems, these are a very 2 marks or 3 marks problems, small problems. But going into this particular classification, we have to get an idea that so these are considered only when you are considering a finite duration. Okay, whatever sequence you are taking, if you are taking a finite duration, then the three classification of problems you can solve. So when if you are taking infinite duration, if you are taking, then the problem will be like this. So how to solve, I will tell later. So first let me explain. So how to solve the finite duration casual sequence or one sided or right handed. So how it will be means, see. So they will give you a sequence. Suppose they will give you a sequence like x of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like this they have given. Okay. And if you are indicating the arrow like this. Arrow, whenever you they will give you the question like this and they will ask you to calculate Z transform. Okay. So this Z transform is to be calculated means this is of finite duration. Okay. So here the arrow mark indicates this is the position x of 0. So if this is the arrow present here, this is 0, then it will become x of plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4. Like this the positions will be there. Now why we have to write this mean? See, first of all, what we will do in order to solve the solution as usual.
Minus 3, we have to write down
minus 1, 0. Like that, you have to substitute. That one also I will show you. So, you get the clear idea. So, x of z is equal to sigma. There is no need to write again sigma, only expansion you have to do. So if in the place of n I am substituting value, see here already z power minus n is there. But here I am substituting minus 3 value. Minus 3 minus will become plus. So here it becomes z power plus 3. And here you will substitute minus 3, it will become z power plus 2. And here you will substitute x of minus 1 z power plus 1, x of 0 z power 0. So, x of minus 3 value, what is arrow is here, no? X of minus 3 value is this one. Means 5, z power plus 3. 6, z power plus 2. And x of minus 1, 7, z power plus 1. And x of 0 value is 8, z power 0 value is 1. Right? So, you can write it as 5 z cube plus 6 z square plus 7 z plus 8. So this is the equation you will obtain after calculating z transform for the left hand side sequence. Okay, and before concluding this video, I would like to just only the small difference for two sided sequence. Only the difference is, suppose 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this, if they have given you, if they ask you to calculate for this, if this is like the arrow is in the middle, then you have to consider this x of 0, x of plus 1, x of plus 2. This one will become x of minus 1, x of minus 2. Means it is a combination of both casual sequence and non-casual. Or it is a combination of left-handed and right-handed sequence. So you have to substitute same equation you will take, but the values will be from minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. Then the equation, how it will be there? Then the output you will get, the substitution I will show you. See, here the position is starting from minus 2. And it is ending at plus 2. X of n, z power minus n. If you wanted to expand, how you can write it? X of minus 2, z power plus 2. X of plus minus 1, z power plus 1. X of 0, z power 0. Plus x of plus 1, z power minus 1. X of 2, x power minus 2. Like this you will write. So x of minus 2 plus what is there here? 1. So the equation will be like 1 z power plus 2 plus 2 z power plus 1 plus 3 into 1 plus 4 into z power minus 1 plus 5 z power minus 2. So this is the equation for two-sided sequence. Okay, so you can write it as x of z is equal to 1z square plus 2z plus 3 plus 4z power minus 1 plus 5z power minus 2. So here if you observe this equation, it is a combination of both left-handed side and right-handed side equation. So that is the main difference you have to observe. And another type of question answers you have to give is, they may ask you the ROC for this finite duration also. So the how to answer for this ROC means, so properties of ROC will be there. Means that is also called as constraints on ROC. So for left handed sequence, right handed sequence, you will have the ROC, that one you have to write. So if they ask only, you have to write in the examination. Otherwise how to solve the procedure, I have told you now. So in this video I have told you about Z transform, different types of Z transform. And in Z transform, in order to solve, I told you in this video, for finite duration, there are three types of sequence, left-handed, right-handed and two-sided sequence. How to solve those problems and how to convert the given sequence into Z-transform, I have told in this video. Okay, and there is also another type of problem, that is infinite duration. So if you wanted to know the infinite duration, so you have to solve the procedure by substituting the limits. That one you can discuss in another video. Thank you.